It's a 10-apartment building, and we have deployed solar and wind resources here to stay totally off-grid. We have about 40 living rooms here, and we also have a water system that is about 50,000, actually 57,000 to be precise, 57,000 liters of water pumping system, which is also run by a solar-powered borehole. We have about 140 units of 200-watt solar PV system on the rooftop, and we also have about 10 units of 1.5 kilowatt wind turbines on the rooftop. So the hybrid of the wind and solar is what sustains this building. Even at night, when the sun is not there, the wind turbines will actually generate some energy, you know, to add to the batteries. At least that will push, get the battery going. And the wind and solar, you know, is hybridized, so they work together to charge the batteries. On the building itself, we actually put into consideration three factors. First of all, is the eco-friendliness of the building. You know, from the architectural stage, we were able to ensure that we did proper ventilation and came up with a kind of architecture that sustains green energy. As you can see, we have just within this living room, we have about three windows and then another very large one at the dining. This actually helps us with ventilation. It's a south-oriented wind that comes in from this part of the building, and as long as you have windows open, there is consistent flow of air from one side of the building to the other, and that gives us a very wonderful cross ventilation. In the past 4 months since we've been here, though the weather is quite friendly right now, but notwithstanding, I have not had any reason to run the AC more than once or twice, I think on two occasions. Our rooftop is actually concrete deck, and that also reduces heat penetration into the building and the BTU requirement for cooling. The terrain here, the topography here, we're somewhere at about 590 meters above sea level. That's quite high, about 100 meters higher than other areas in Abuja. And that's what informed the need to deploy the wind turbines, which generates about 15 kilowatts of energy per day. So combined, per apartment, we have a solar generation capacity of about 4 kilowatts per apartment. And that's about enough to, you know, power all the light points. We ensure that we use energy-efficient LED lights throughout the building. So in an apartment, even when you have all the lights turned on, you're consuming less than 1,000 watts of energy. We're also mindful of selecting refrigerators and TVs. We go for the most eco-friendly available ones in the market. We're also using the DC refrigerators in each apartment, which runs strictly on solar battery, and that also helps to ensure that we don't deplete the power as we've saved in the batteries. So each one is programmed to work for a certain number of hours, rests for another given hours. So in that case, we don't run the refrigerator when we don't need it. The deep freezer runs for about 8 hours in a day, and then this runs for about 12 hours in a day. But with the use of these timers, you can program them to run when you need them to run and go off when you don't want them to run. On this building, we have about 70 units of the new improved energy-saving air conditioners. It's called the inverter VACs. It doesn't have starting current to start with, and secondly, it runs at about 30% less the power required to run regular ACs. So that's what we're having here. Normally from the building design, we don't expect you to run all the ACs in each house at a go, but where necessary, you can actually run up to 3 ACs simultaneously, and that 3 ACs can run for not less than 6 hours in a day. So that's to say that you can run 18 hours of air conditioning in each apartment. Interestingly, we have solar water heaters on the rooftop. So those solar water heaters feed into the installed internal water heaters, which are hardly in use. The only thing I will tell you we don't have connected here is the ovens, because that takes very, very high electricity, and we just figured out that we could actually use the gas system for that to resolve that purpose. Now, if you take 30 million as a figure, it sounds ridiculous, it sounds very huge. We actually did a business model and we worked out the finances. And if we include cost of battery replacement for the next 10 years and divide the total cost of the project and maintenance for that 10 years, it comes down to an energy generation of about 970 naira per day per apartment. And I think that is reasonable. This is for uninterrupted power. Most clients don't have access to financing. So the issue of bringing out or coughing out that much money at one go is usually the challenge we're having. And that's why we're encouraging, you know, the relevant agencies of the government to come up with policies, probably financial policies that will support the renewable energy industry, that will support financing of these solutions, where people can actually key into the solutions and then pay over, you know, 2, 3, 5 years, you know. Besides, it will be interesting to note that the current electricity we're enjoying in Nigeria is actually subsidized, you know, and by the time the government takes that subsidy off, which eventually will definitely come, you realize that, you know, on the longer run, the renewable energy, that's the solar, you know, solution is actually cheaper than even the grid solution that is not available as we speak.